Not detailed up to the last T, but isn't the demolition and the new design tied together? I mean, you really can't demolish one without knowing what you're doing on the other, right?
Yeah, the strong preference of all the regulatory agencies is to submit what you intend to put back as part of what you intend to demolish, you know, a package, so to speak. In the case of the Swift Flood and Corps of Engineers, when we get those permits, they're in effect for 5 years. We are authorized to demolish the existing structure. We're authorized to also place certain materials along the shoreline of the north-south outwooded runway. If the LEZ does not go forward due to a vote or other action, we would then be compelled to put a permit modification to Swift Mud and the Corps of Engineers as to what we propose to build in lieu of the LEZ. But we are still entitled to demolish it. In the case of the county, we would do the same thing. We would submit a permit modification or an amended permit request to extract any of the replacement features of that permit application. So, to make a long story short, when we get these permits, we're entitled to demo. If we don't build the LEZ, we're then compelled to submit what we intend to build and seek out an amendment and an approval to that amendment from the regulatory agencies.
Thank you, Councilman.